4 days now, we have been following this wake of white flakes toward our next adventure. It's a migratory flight of butterflies killed by the radioactivity in these waters. We are on the Pacific Ocean, just a few miles from Bikini. 10 years ago, when the last American atomic bomb was exploded in this zone, some species of birds, such as these, who habitually went underground only to lay their eggs and to hatch them, learned that they had to stay underground in order to survive. This habit, taught them by the explosion, was inherited by successive generations, so much so that today, these birds prefer to be captured rather than to fly away from their holes. This is but one sign of the profound changes undergone by animal life on this poisoned archipelago. Everywhere, the animals seem to have lost faith in their natural habitat. Even certain fish, like this type of Pteriophthalmus, for example, who normally can live out of the water for only a brief time, have not only learned to leave the water for many hours a day, but have taken to the trees. Thousands of eggs that will never hatch cover the atolls. They are seagull eggs, hern eggs, gannet eggs, sterile eggs, dead even before they are laid. The seabird has gone to search for food, but each evening, as it has done for years now, it returns punctually to hatch them. It doesn't know that the atom has killed the seeds of life within. Atomic contamination has had an even more tragic effect on the sea turtle. When its last sad maternity is finished, it can't find its way back to the sea. Contamination has destroyed all sense of direction. Tired and lost, instead of heading toward the sea, she drags herself inland, where the sun and fatigue will kill her. Barret eggs have hatched on this island, and the chicks look on her agony in amazement. The turtle, in one last delusion, thinks she has finally returned to swim in the sea. Turtles die each day on the scorching desert sand. Some barrets have made their nests in the large skeletons. The chicks search for scraps of meat among the bones.